Hi friends, today we will do transcription number 47. So, ready? Start. Madam, you are aware that when this life business was nationalized in the year 1956, great expectation and great hopes were entertained by all members of parliament. In the statement of object and reason relating to that measure, the finance minister stated that nationalization was necessary and even imperative to achieve the broad objective of increasing insurance business to take it to larger area, including the rural area, and to give greater return to policy holder. We have to see after these few years of the working of this organization how far we have achieved this great objective. In the passage also, we may remember that many criticisms have been made in regard to the working of this organization. Even the estimate committee has gone into this question and examined in detail the various aspects of the working of this organization. That committee has made certain recommendations. Those recommendations are very important and I will advert to them shortly. Before I deal with them, I wish to make one point clear. In spite of the various comments made in the House, in the press, and also through various organizations, the working of this organization has not been improved very much. The report which we are discussing today relates to the year 1966. Obviously, it is a very old document, and a discussion on this report at this hour perhaps is too late. Nevertheless, a discussion is important if we keep in view some of the fundamental problems that are facing this organization. This report was submitted in November 1961, that is to say, some 9 months after the period of the working of this organization. I do not know why there should be such inordinate delay in submitting report. The report, madam, deal with various aspects. It does not bring out many things which ought to be brought properly in a report of this kind. And while reading this report, I was not able to make out the working of this organization and to get a proper understanding of it. For that purpose, I have to depend upon other report and other opinion expressed by various organizations in this country, and thereby I have to gather information. That is why I have to suggest that the report should be comprehensive. I would refer to some of the important problems confronting this organization. The most important among them, in my opinion, is the organizational setup. You remember when this matter came up for discussion in both House of Parliament at the time of nationalization of this life business suggestion were made by certain members. I was participating in the other house in the debate then, and I suggested that one corporation would not be better, and it is desirable to have more than one organization, to have more than one corporation. I suggested this, and a good many members of my party made this suggestion because they thought that there should be some sort of comparative standards to measure the efficiency and performance of this organization. Without such comparative standard to the measure the efficiency and the work of this organization, it would be difficult to judge either the efficiency of the organization. Therefore, we suggested that there should be more than one corporation. Perhaps there should be three or four. Now, after the experience gained, the estimate committee has come to this conclusion that this is a huge monolithic organization whose task has been increasing all the time, and that it has not been possible for this organization to fulfill all the expectation and all the task and all the requirement that are expected to be fulfilled by this organization. And so the estimate committee has suggested a radical change, a revolutionary departure with regard to the organizational setup. They have advisedly pointed out two alternatives. The first alternative is to set up more than one corporation so that there may be division of work and division of areas. There may also be healthy competition between the corporation so that the country and the people may know which corporation is doing better and which is not doing better. The other alternative they have suggested is that there should be one organization which is federal structure with a semi-zonal unit functioning. Therefore, I also submit that with this monolithic structure, it would be difficult for the organization to carry out its function more efficiently and in a direction which is healthy and which is progressive. In the first instance, therefore, I would suggest that the ministry should immediately take steps to see that the whole organizational setup is revised and reorganized so that there may be better efficiency and understanding maintained into the working of this great institution. The organization as it is constituted reveals certain inherent defects. The main office is managed by a large number of officials. Thank you. Please subscribe my channel Steno Star.